Hey guys, Cardiac Killer here with another walkthrough video for ActRaiser Renaissance. In this video, we are gonna be finishing up the location of Bloodpool, Act 2, and gonna be working on Cassandora, the next region. So, we're gonna jump right into it. What do I have to do? Ah, that's right. So, in the last video that we did, we learned a little bit about Bloodpool, about the area. The one caveat with Bloodpool in the missions where you have to protect Teddy is that, unlike the other, unlike the heroes prophesized that you have control of, like Daniela here, like Philotas of Fillmore, you cannot actually move Teddy. And so that does at times cause a little bit of problems. Especially in a scenario like this, when right off the bat he's gonna start taking damage. So if you want to avoid him taking a lot of unnecessary damage, you can use the elements to be able to take care of things. Or you can just wait till Daniela gets there and she can just lay out. Cause with her magic being an AoE, an area of effect thing, she can clear out groups fast. I need to put you up here. Right there. Absolutely needed to do that. No, I want to put you over here. Tower's got that. That. Come on, get over there, Philotas. I don't even care if it doesn't do a lot, it's better than nothing. Oof. Oh well. I have another one. And so you'll notice with these victory conditions, like this one specifically, in the bottom corner there, you see all the different conditions. That one, the tower that was just destroyed was one of my mage houses, and so I have only one left now. So I definitely have to keep that one alive or else I am hosed. Stop. Alright, move it down there, Buster. Oh yeah, there it is. Easy steps. Oh yeah, but in the last video we learned a little bit more about the situation and everything. Daniela here has basically been living as a slave to Zeppelin Wolf, who is one of the chosen of the Dark Lord Tanzra. He basically has told the people of Bloodpool that he wants them to either leave, or he will take one of theirs as a sacrifice whenever he sees fit, basically. And the people have told him, no, we're gonna do neither, and you're gonna deal with it. Which is kind of where we're at now, is this stage. He just attacked us because of us basically fighting him. And yeah, that's where we're at now. We're gonna be fighting soon. Right now. What the heck's going on out there? Thank you. Gotta love having three different businesses that are all right there getting crashed on at the same time. So those statues are kind of annoying. You'll want to definitely avoid those, you know, just by crouching into those. Or you can attempt to jump over them. But I like to just crouch because it's a sure way to do it. So normally this path would not be a thing. But with the remaster, with the new stuff that they've added in, there's actually one of the scrolls that you can collect over here now. I love this music. And so the beautiful thing now that I was able to pick up the ice magic from Teddy and Daniela. Is that I have the ability now to switch magics, and how you do that is if you're running a controller, you would hold your Y or your triangle button or whatever your top button is, and it just, what it does is you'll notice on the left corner underneath your little character icon there, you'll see a little circle that will fill up, and when the circle fills up, then it pulls up your magic, and it does actually pause the game here as well, so you don't have to worry about, like, taking damage or anything like that, unless you're about to take damage, in which case, as soon as you come out of this, then you'll probably end up taking your damage, but then you can swap between your available magics at will, and so the Penitent Ice does the same kind of thing as the fire, it just does it on the ground instead, and it imbues you with ice damage instead of the fire damage, like how the radiant fire does. Ow. Killing that statue is not going to be the end of the world. And so over here, once that door opens up, is going to be another little scroll. As well as a bunch of enemies to kill to be able to make sure that you're getting as buffed as you can by picking up the crystals. can see right there, I'm already maxed out before I even get to the next checkpoint. And so as long as I don't die, then I will keep my revive, which is the little shield icon that's in the yellow circle. And then the 2 plus 100 is plus 100 to, plus 100 to strength, and or plus 100 to attack, and plus 100 to magic. And so I missed one somewhere. Which one did I miss? Oh well. And now we fight in the boss. Zip the Wolf. This fight is kind of an interesting fight because this fight's actually broken down into two parts. The first part is him in his human form, which is as you see right here, and he's casting, you know, the magics and stuff. And then once you get his health down to zero, then he transforms into the Wolfie. Again, we are playing on normal, which is why these fights might seem as easy as they are with buffed up and everything, is because they're not overly challenging. But they do still require you to pay attention and focus, because otherwise you will lose. I have lost. I lost my very first playthrough of this, you know, with me being as very familiar with the original game as I was. It did help a lot with levels and fight mechanics and things like that, but I still had my fair share of deaths that happened in that playthrough, even on normal. I need to rebuild Blood Pool. Don't know. I think I already did the rebuild on Blood Pool. If anything, I would be doing the rebuild just to see the layout and how it would look. And you can even see right over here, you know, the castle's all busted up and everything, because we just went in there and slayed out. There's not anything else going on. I do think I'm gonna do a rebuild on Blood Pool. Why not? get my SP back real quick. I wonder how long into the rebuild it will trigger what I'm expecting it to trigger. And so now that I got the second jewel, the jewel of the warden, now at any given point I could bring Daniela into one of my worlds, even if I was to get attacked here in Fillmore, I could bring in her to help. Cool, I did get them all. Thought I missed one. But yeah, when you're doing the act mode, you'll notice that the little pillars and everything that I've been breaking to get the... Okay, I guess 18 wasn't enough. Just go and get a couple of things from over here. But yeah, there's the two different item pillars. You'll have the white one, which is your basic one, where you'll have, you know, your MP plus 20s and your HP plus 50 items. The little magic potion and the half apple, which the half apple is an item that was in the original game. And it did replenish just a little bit of your health. And then in the gold item totems, you have your scrolls, which there's three per level. And those give you a permanent increase to your MP as well as like an MP. Like plus 10 to your MP or something like that across, and so it's like that's easy enough. And then they also have the plus 100 apples, which is the full apple, which in the original game the full apple would replenish all of your health. But in a game like this, where you actually have a number attached to it, it does make a little bit more sense to be able to replenish your health by a number instead of just by filling up a meter. Because in the original, you had just like little tick marks that each time you would get hit, the tick marks would turn from blue to red, indicating how much damage you've taken. Oh wow, it'll actually do it right now. Now, will it still let me build on this? Nope. So. So, what happened here, granted, you can't see anything because there's no buildings or anything, but what happened basically is that the people of Bloodpool, after we killed Zeppelin Wolf, the people of Bloodpool started getting antsy with each other and they started bickering. And so, while they're bickering, they won't build. They won't do anything. And so you have to find a way to be able to calm them down so that way they can stop bickering at each other. and go back to being friends. And so for the time being, we're finished with Bloodpool. And we're going to be moving over to the next area, which is Cassandra. Same thing here. We're going in right on Act 1, right off the bat. Going in so that way we can get a foothold in the area and we can get our church building right there. Bam. Or temple, excuse me. And you'll notice here, Cassandra is a desert. And so you're going to have your spike elements to worry about here is going to be cactuses. And you'll also notice the new type of enemy, which is these spear-throwing dudes. And here you will have to be a little bit careful of your foothold, because the slopes are actually slopes, and they will slide you down. Now, I would suggest for any new players to this game that I would suggest that you at least start on normal, unless you're one of those that's like a super glutton for punishment. Then by all means, start on the harder difficulty. Just note that when you are playing on hard, things will hurt a lot. Like, you see me get hit, and I take a little bit of damage, and I'm like, ow. But things hurt a lot. And you see right there, the scroll gives a +10. A +10 permanent, and a +10, permanent +10, and, a +10 regen. And the physics and things in this game are kind of wonky. As you see, I'm standing in enemies and taking damage. I don't have any explanation for that. I really don't. And since I'm already maxed out, we roll out and we're chilling, going to the boss. So for this one here, for this boss, I like to use the Penitent Ice magic, because a lot of the time he's spent in the ground. And you'll definitely want to make use of dodge back. And then from here, you just kind of spam on him until he dies. But yeah, the enemies are definitely a lot tankier and hard. And especially including the bosses. Like, there's no way I could pull that off as quickly and easily as I could. Now without taking a lot more damage. Definitely keep that in mind if you're going to be playing on the harder difficulty. So this is Cassimdora, like I said, it's a desert. And so you'll have to work around that, which is not too bad. But the desert people need your help to be able to clear things out, so that way they can build on the ground. And so that's where your rain comes in, which I am dumb and forgot that I used all my SP to blow up all the things in Blood Pool, so we gotta go to Fillmore to get more. But yeah, Cassimdora is the third area that we're going to be working on, and I had a train of thought there and then it's gone. It'll come back to me eventually. And I do apologize for the background noise to anybody who watches. I do live at a very, very busy area, and so there's a lot of traffic and things that go by outside. But yeah, please, if you have any questions, definitely leave them in the comments, and I will do my best to reply to them either as a reply to the comment or in another video, or possibly even both. That way I can make sure I'm doing my best to help things. Alright. Out, and now we can go over to Cassimdora. And so you can see right there, you know, the little bit of pink that's right there, that is a monster lair. Wrong button. Rain. You can see the dude ski right there, which, that actually even was a thing in the original game as well, the dude in the desert. And I will try to keep this video shorter. Than the last couple of videos. But we'll see what happens. Now these spawners do start getting a little bit hard as you progress in the game, so you're definitely going to want to be careful with them, because they're not just going to be a walk in the park the entire time, like how some of them have been. You die. You want 300 materials. I have zero currently. I've not even built anything yet. You're gonna give me a wall. Wow, thanks. You know, let's go with it. I got friends I can bring in. I got friends and I got elements. Let's see what I can do. No, it's gonna take damage. Oh well. Nope. I gotta keep you here. Gotta bring you here. Could have actually went a lot worse. Thank you. It's nice when they're nice and simple like that, and I can stand on a straight platform. Thank you. We're gonna get another couple of defenses before we do this one, though. Because I've gotten really unlucky with my warehouse draws. And my... I want to at least get another couple of defenses on there. Okay, well now I'm maxed out on walls, so anything that they make is going to be supplies, so that will at least be nice. But I've found, especially when you're in a new area that you're trying to level up like this, a lot of the time it's easier to leave the things as they are until you are done, because that way you could, like, because if I was to have started rebuilding to get level 2 stuff, I would have to wait to get all new workshops and everything to be able to get supplies, which would mean that I wouldn't be able to have any progress working towards building defenses. Because the supplies for each area do not carry over. Spot I'll have to be careful of is this spot right here. But if nothing else, I got heroes I can put there. Thank you. I need about 360 supplies to be able to upgrade the rest of my stuff.
Thank you.
I didn't lose any defenses though, which is huge. And make short work of it, I shall. Ow. That'll work. So that bell is an interesting little thing. How it works is you put it down the same way you would a wall, and what it does is it will lure enemies to it. So it's beautiful for setting up like traps at a tower and stuff like that. Or for luring enemies away from a choke point where you know they're going to be flooding to be able to keep things away. Thank you. The only caveat with the bell is that you can only use three of them per fight. So it's not like you have like an infinite amount of them or anything like that. You do have to be, you know, careful with them. Because otherwise you'll just burn them all. Go for Lotus. No. Thank you.
Thank you.
So the hardest part about this is literally just waiting to get the supplies and everything that you need to upgrade everything. Do one more big lightning strike over here. Probably be a 25. I don't know if an 18 would work on that. That's too little big. Yeah, no, I need a 25 to be able to hit all of it. That'll do it. But once you get level 3 stuff in there, it makes getting the supplies go really fast. Really? And part of why I did the rebuild early on this was because one of my objectives was to get level 3 workshops, so I had to get the high-end stuff, which meant that I had to blow up existings. So I figured I might as well get a head start on rebuilding everything. And you see Cassandora's, excuse me, you see Cassandora's population just skyrockets. Cassandora is also one of the biggest areas, though, too. So it's only natural for its population to just absolutely skyrocket. Thank you.
Oh, that one's done for. There's way too many ifrits there.
Let's give him some fodder. Thank you. think about how I want to do that. And so for now, this is actually where we are going to call it for this video. I want to thank y'all for watching. Make sure you hit that like button, subscribe if you have not already, and we will see you in the next one.